Select the tables which represent y as a function of x. Recall that a function is a relation in which each input or x value has exactly one output or corresponding y value. Looking at this first table, notice the x value of positive 1 occurs twice in the table. So the x value of positive 1 has an output of positive 3. It also has an output of positive 16. This indicates the input or x value of positive 1 has two corresponding outputs or two y values, and therefore this first table is not a function. Again, the table is a function if each input or x value has exactly one output or corresponding y value. Just to emphasize this, let's go ahead and map this first relation. Looking at the x values, notice the domain would be negative 4, 1, 6, and 8. Remember, we only list the x value of 1 once. We do not list it twice, even though it occurs twice in the table. And the range would be negative 1, 3, 9, and 16. And now to show the relation, we draw an arrow from negative 4 in the domain to negative 1 in the range. We draw an arrow from 1 to 3. We draw an arrow from 6 to 3. We draw an arrow from 8 to 9. And we draw an arrow from 1 to 16. Focusing on the domain value or x value of 1, we can easily see the x value of 1 has two corresponding outputs or two corresponding y values, which is why the table is not a function. Looking at the second table, focusing on the x values, notice none of the x values in the table are listed more than once, and therefore there's no way any of the x values or inputs could have more than one corresponding output or y value, and therefore this table is a function. Every input has exactly one corresponding output, and therefore we check this table. Let's also map this function to make the result more obvious. The domain is negative 4, 2, 5, 7, and 15. And the range is 0, 1, 9, and 14. Negative 4 has an output of 0, 2 has an output of 1, 5 has an output of 1, 7 has an output of 9, and 15 has an output of 14. Notice each input has exactly one corresponding output, and therefore the table does represent a function. Notice it's okay for the inputs to share an output. Notice 2 has an output of 1, and 5 has an output of 1, but 2 and 5 still only have one corresponding output. Looking at the third table, again, let's focus on the x values. The x values, or domain, are the elements negative 1, 3, 5, 8, and 16. None of the x values appear more than once in the table, and therefore each input or each x value has exactly one corresponding output. The third table is also a function. You may want to map this relation to verify that it is a function. And then finally, for the fourth table, focusing on the domain or the x values, notice the x value of 1 appears twice in the table. The input or x value of 1 has an output of 3 and an output of 5. Because the input of 1 has more than one corresponding output, this table does not represent a function, and we do not check the box. Again, you may want to map this relation to verify it is not a function. I hope you found this helpful.